that sound? Dun 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 dun. And suddenly, thousands of people all around the world were afraid to ever swim again. Jaws, the blockbuster that branded sharks as Hollywood's favorite villain. Even my sister, she still gets nightmares about that dorsal fin slicing through the water. All because our babysitter figured it was a good movie for a 10-year-old. But this movie was so effective that psychologists even gave it a name. The Jaws effect, where we have this irrational fear of sharks intentionally hunting us. Hands up here, who has been affected by the Jaws effect? Look around, the Jaws effect in action. But what if I told you that sharks aren't the monsters that we've made them out to be, but that we actually depend on them for a healthy ocean? Because if we lose sharks, we risk collapsing fisheries, destabilizing our climate, unraveling entire ecosystems, putting quite literally our future at stake. Now, sharks are over 400 million years old, with over 500 different species adapted to every ocean environment imaginable. From the Greenland shark that lives centuries in the icy deep, to the giant whale shark that cruises through our tropics. Yet, in just a few decades, human actions have pushed these resilient survivors to the absolute brink. And now, they may not survive us. And believe it or not, this affects every single one of us. Because when we lose sharks, we lose the ocean as we know it, its balance and its resilience. Sharks are keystone species, which means they keep prey in check, they remove the sick and weak, and they hold entire food webs together. Remove that keystone, and entire ecosystems can collapse. We've already seen this happen. In places like the Caribbean, when reef sharks disappeared, mid-level predators like grippers exploded in numbers. They overate the herbivore fish that normally keep algae in check. And without them, this green algae smothered the reef, stripping it of its biodiversity and function. And when ocean ecosystems unravel, it's not just marine life that suffers. It's us, our food, our economies, even our climate security. So, you might be wondering, where did my love of sharks even come from? Well, I grew up in Donegal Bay, lucky to be raised in the ocean. But as a child, I was obsessed with nature documentaries, especially David Attenborough. He would transport me to these weird, wild, and wonderful ocean ecosystems all around the world. And he introduced me to sharks in a way that felt magical. I remember sitting down, remote in one hand, pen in the other, pause button at the ready to write down any ocean facts he would say, creating my own little record of ocean stories. That childhood obsession eventually pulled me very far from Donegal Bay, all the way to a tiny island in Fiji called Benga, where I volunteered doing shark conservation. This was my first ever solo trip and my first real plunge into their world. Now, despite knowing a lot of facts, I was still really nervous the first time that I got to dive with bull sharks and tiger sharks, the headline-making type of sharks. I can still feel that moment. Dive gear on, heart racing. stepping off the boat's edge, sinking through the layers of liquid blue. 5 meters, 10 meters. Only the sound of me breathing in and out. And then, bull shark. Suddenly all that noise in my head just went quiet. I was completely awestruck. And then a tiger shark, easily twice her size, just cruised past. She was curious and graceful. I couldn't help but admire their torpedo-shaped bodies that was just built for speed, all while their massive fins kept them in perfect synchrony, all while they kept a calm and steady watch. Then creatures, I realized then that those creatures were just sculpted to perfection by the hand of evolution. Not monsters, but masterpieces. That moment underwater changed everything for me, and I came home more determined than ever to study marine science. But here's what should change everything for you. Sharks don't just keep life underwater in balance. They even help shape our climate. The ocean is our greatest defense against climate change. Take seagrass meadows. They're carbon sinks that store and capture much more carbon than tropical rainforests. And sharks, they help keep these ecosystems intact. It's called the ecology of fear, where predators don't just hunt, but their very presence influences how other animals behave. Take Shark Bay in Australia. Tiger sharks patrol these meadows. They keep turtles and other herbivores on the move. Without them, these herbivores can linger, strip the seagrass bare, causing that ecosystem to collapse, adding to the climate crisis. So, sharks aren't just biodiversity builders. They're also unsung climate heroes. Despite their critical roles, sharks are in serious trouble. According to the IUCN Red List, over one-third of shark species are now facing extinction. Why? Overfishing and global trade. This is driven by a billion-dollar industry that hunts sharks for their meat, their fins, their liver oil, and their cartilage. And this isn't just happening far out at sea. It's turning up in our everyday lives. Quick show of hands. Who here likes fish for dinner? Recent DNA studies have found that critically endangered shark is ending up in our food chain, often mislabeled as things like rock salmon or flake, or simply labeled as shark, with no species listed, misleading consumers. And it doesn't stop there. That anti-aging cream, that sunscreen that we wear to the beach, many can contain shark squalene, which is an oily compound found in shark livers. And what makes this even worse is that the marketing behind their demise for profit is deeply misleading. I want you to feel the top of your ear for a moment. That flexible tissue is called cartilage, and shark skeletons are made up of a similar flexible tissue. The only difference is shark cartilage is grounded down to a powdered pill and marketed as a cure for arthritis, even though there's very little scientific evidence to back that claim. And shark meat? It's promoted as a healthy source of protein. Yet, it is loaded with mercury, which is a toxin linked to neurological and developmental problems in humans. So, both knowingly and indeed unknowingly, we are erasing these ancient predators one purchase at a time. And while these industries grow richer, the ocean pays the price. But there is hope. We can rewrite this story, because when we protect sharks, everybody wins. In the Bahamas, protecting sharks paid off. Now, divers from all around the world go there to shark dive, adding over $100 million annually to that local economy. And in Palau, a Pacific nation, they've protected sharks across their entire waters. And now one shark alive throughout its entire lifespan is worth nearly $2 million through tourism. Much, much more than its fins ever could. And here in Ireland, we have our own story of resilience. The basking shark received full legal protection in 2022. We're already seeing sightings increasing, and coastal communities are building ecotourism around their return. So these stories prove something powerful. Conservation isn't just good for sharks. It's good for people too. As I think back to that little girl scribbling down her notes like her life depended on it, I can't help but think about all the other children around the world who, like me, may be watching these documentaries, seeing the Great Barrier Reef just vibrant with color and life, or seeing these giant kelp forests swaying with the tide. Or maybe they're just looking out at the ocean with that same sense of wonder and awe. You never know, maybe they want to go shark diving too someday, just like I did. But I can't help but wonder, what kind of future are we leaving them? What happens if we continue writing the same story, where profit comes before protection? What happens if we continue to ignore the crisis unfolding beneath the waves, where this mass destruction and mass consumption of species and habitats doesn't stop? What kind of future will they inherit? What kind of future will we inherit? The answer depends on what we do right now. We all have a responsibility and an opportunity to stand up for our oceans, but we need to do it now. We can start by rethinking how we see sharks. Remember how important they are to both ocean and planetary health. Refuse to fuel their decline. As consumers, every choice and every purchase matters. Raise your voice and stand together. Demand better protections from our governments and policymakers for our oceans. And stand with all the scientists, the NGOs, and the communities all around the world that are fighting so tirelessly for our oceans. Because when we protect sharks, we protect our ocean. And when we protect our ocean, we protect our future. Thank you.